Good morning, Eagle Nation. It's Monday, and if you're here, I'm glad you are here. And if you're not here, we miss you. Please join me for a moment of silence. Thank you. And now, your morning announcements.
What color is the sky? Ay, mi amor, ay, mi amor. You tell me that it's red. Ay, mi amor, ay, mi amor. Where should I put my shoes? Ay, mi amor, you say, put them on your head. Ay, mi amor.
That's right, Eagle Nation. Today is the 67th day of school. It's the 14th of November, and I would love to let that song keep playing, but copyright laws won't allow me to do so. Nevertheless, I want to dedicate that song, or rather, Mr. Mosier would like to dedicate that song. That was Un Poco Loco by Anthony Gonzalez and Gael Garcia Bernal from the movie Coco. He dedicates that song to Jude and all my kindergarten friends in Ms. Brown's class who are un poco loco and whom I miss so much. That song dedication is for you, kindergartners. Thank you, Mr. Mosier, for ringing in this Monday. On this Monday, lots going on. First and foremost, I must apologize because I learned something. While I completed, with the help of many of you, we completed the WAG well in advance, and I told you on Friday in the PA announcement, it'll be ready by 5 p.m. and delivered auto delivery. Then I closed my computer. And I learned that when my computer is closed, even if Outlook is an online platform, it doesn't matter. It does not send until I reopen my computer. So unfortunately, it didn't get sent until 7:38 a.m. That is my fault. I do apologize. All I can say is I've learned and I will do better. In the WAG this week though, teachers, if you haven't yet seen it, please check it out because there is lots going on. Students, you should know that this week, for example, we also have the Turkey Trot coming up, and I'll have a schedule out to you. My goal is to get that to you by the end of the day today so that you know when you are doing it. It'll likely be on Thursday or Friday, and it will be during your recess. If you win, you get to take home a turkey to your family for Thanksgiving, or if you win but you would like to donate it in this season of gratitude and thanks, you always could gift your turkey to someone else. Half the fun is the process itself. So look forward to our Turkey Trot later this week. If you have parents or family that would like to come and watch, just let them know it will be at your recess time on Thursday or Friday. I'll confirm by the end of the day. They're welcome to do so. They just would need to sign in at the front office, and then they can come and watch and take pictures if they want and celebrate you if you happen to be our Turkey Trotter. So look forward to that. I'm getting ahead of myself. So wherever you may be, please stop. Please stand, let us rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, and I apologize for doing things out of order. Well, let's join and do 10 push-ups if you're with me. Let's knock them out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Excellent. Congratulations to our flag football team. If you didn't already know, on Thursday of last week, they did not win. So my congratulations is not about them winning the tournament. My congratulations is in saying you made all of us proud. You made Mr. Santos proud and Coach Jesse proud as well. We saw a team that a year ago was struggling to stay positive in moments of challenge. This year, we did a much better job, and Coach Santos, Coach Jesse, and even in the games that I witnessed this year, and I only got a chance to see two. But I will say, I also was impressed and proud of how you stayed positive in the difficult moments. And because of it, look how far you got. Now, We use defeat as fuel for the next season. Soccer season's around the corner. Or for next year's flag football. But either way, when times get tough, stay positive, and you will accomplish so much more than if you start to become cynical, if you start to rag on your teammates, if you start to put your head down and put yourself down. Instead, pick yourself up, and you can accomplish amazing things. So thank you to our flag football team. You make us all proud. If you know somebody in your class who is a flag football player, congratulate them. They are leaders. In other news, we have stars on our campus. The Star Awards, if you haven't nominated yet for class one certified, one classified personnel, I won't show you their names yet, but I want you to know I got one, two, three, at least four nominations. Keep them coming all day long. This is for one certified, one classified staff. You have till the end of the week to get me your nomination. What a great way to show your appreciation during this season of thanks. Also, memoirs are come flowing in. Look at all these by the kindergarten students. And I know some of you in seventh and eighth have also been working on these. And I know one of you in third grade also has been working on a memoir. I'm still working on mine, sadly, because I promised you one and it's taken me longer than I thought. But you have until the end of the week to get your memoirs turned in for our writing contest. And we would love to see them and celebrate you. So if you haven't done it yet, think about it. Now. Oh, yes. Our continued celebration of American Indian Heritage Month. And so today, I thought I would bring back an oldie but a goodie. What am I talking about? I'm talking about dream catchers. If you've never been in my office, you'll see on the wall, there is a painting. It's an ink and watercolor, actually, of a dream catcher. And this was something that I purchased, actually, from a student 4 years ago. And I've had it hanging on my wall. And thank you, Ms. Brown in kindergarten. She, a year ago, brought this to our attention and says this about dream catchers. Dream catchers are traditionally made of willow branches and can be decorated with feathers and beads. The circular frame symbolizes Mother Earth and everything that sustains life. Its circular shape represents the continuous flow of life, as there is no beginning or end. In addition to representing the circle of life, it also symbolizes how the sun and moon move across the sky in a continuous loop. The web or net of the dream catchers is intricately woven inside the frame to mimic the look of a spider's web. The circle in the center of the web is its heart and where the good dreams and visions are filtered through. She says, "As a child, the tribe my mom worked with gave her one for me and blessed me. It is one of my most prized possessions and one of my favorite native traditions." Thank you, Ms. Brown. And if you'd like to see an image, you can scroll on our Google site. It's actually above this video, and see a picture of that dream catcher that is posted in my office. Now some words of wisdom so you can finally get to the business of teaching and learning today. Today's on the topic of gratitude and jealousy. Do you know the green-eyed monster? The monster that gets jealous of other people because they have nicer clothes or a better cell phone, better toys, or more friends, better grades. When the green-eyed monster gets jealous, he wishes he had the same things, and he wishes that other people didn't. The green-eyed monster can be mean and angry. But listen to this. The next time you feel the green-eyed monster hanging around you, you can chase him away. Just stop and think about all the things you have to be grateful for. All the good and wonderful things in your life. The green-eyed monster doesn't like that one bit, and he won't stick around. So today, and every day, remember to be happy for all you have, and then you can be happy for what others have too. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Mask up today. Hats, hoods, and sunglasses off indoors. Then stay in your zone, put away your phones, and make it a great day or not. The choice is yours. Oh, the way you keep me guessing, I'm nodding and I'm guessing. I'll count it as a blessing that I'm only un poco loco.